time to celebrate these holy women among us, who for 75, 70, and 60 years have lived and continue to live their life's commitment as daughters of wisdom. Sister Emma, Sister Irene, Sister Louise, Sister Marie, Sister Diane, and Sister Kathy, thank you.
said, I have compassion for these people. They have already been with me 3 days and have nothing to eat. I do not want to send them away hungry, or they may collapse on the way. His disciples answered, where could we get enough bread in this remote place to feed such a crowd? How many loaves do you have? Jesus asked. Seven, they replied, and a few small fish. He told the crowd to sit down on the ground. Then he took the seven loaves and the fish, and when he had given thanks, he broke them and gave them to the disciples, and in turn to the people. They all ate and were satisfied. Afterward, the disciples picked up seven full baskets of broken pieces that were left over. The number of those who ate were 4,000, men besides women. The Gospel of Lord Jesus Christ.
Each time we gather around her table, as we do here at the Eucharist,
Jesus was, is, the one among us, showing us how to live our call, to care for others who hunger, for food, for companionship, for spiritual nourishment, to support those in harm's way, and to nurture those who are fearful and doubting. While trusting we have what we need, even if it doesn't always look that way, trusting that we can count on our companions for support, trusting that Jesus, incarnate wisdom, remains in our midst, broadening our vision and deepening our compassion. Together, we have more than we need. How many baskets? Too many to count, and yet more than enough. One of my go-to passages of wisdom comes to me in us through Rabbi Rabbi Shapiro. He does a little transliteration from one aspect of Montfort's work. And he says, he writes, "I do not covet wisdom, nor seek to keep her for myself. On the contrary, I desire to share her, for the welfare of the world depends upon a growing community of the wise." Let me read it again. "I do not covet wisdom, nor seek to keep her for myself. On the contrary, I desire to share her, for the welfare of the world depends upon a growing community of the wise." Each of us gathered here today has become a part of that growing community of the wise. We've shared our gifts, our talents, our resources. We've answered calls. We've gone places we never thought we'd go. And yet, here we are, still seeking wisdom. Each, in his or her own life, has lived out their commitment of their baptism and confirmation and other vows we've taken wholeheartedly. We've maneuvered our way through an amazing array of changes and adaptations over these 60, 70, and 75 years. We all have and continue to navigate the momentous changes in the community of which we are a part, of the nation, the cosmos, all of life, and all that we keep learning about To your table you bid us come, and have set the places, have poured the wine, and there is always room, you say, for one more. From the streets and from the alleys,
we come.
From the ravages of poverty and the places of privilege,
we come.
We are bloody with our wars, we are weary with our wounds, we carry the dead within us, and we reckon with their ghosts. We hold seized feeling, we dream of a new creation. We know the things that make the peace, and we struggle to give them away. And yet,
amen. Jesus, wisdom of God, bless and strengthen our sisters who are celebrating their jubilees this day. The 60 years, Sister Diane Guerette, Sister Cathleen Murtha. 70 years, Sister Irene Arsenault, Sister Louise Dufour, and Sister Marie. 75 years, Sister Evelyn Lamoureux. And we include the 40th anniversary of Sisters Patricia Torrey and Cathleen Sheehan. We pray. Jesus, wisdom of God, welcome into your kingdom our sisters who have completed their earthly pilgrimage. May they share the fullness of your joy in the communion of saints. We pray.
Throughout the ages, we may be married to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
she might be. She might be.
Yes. I'm going to speak as loudly as I can from here. More or less? Okay? All right. So, we're going to obviously continue the celebration so well begun. Right? We'll take just a moment to bless our meal. Gracious God, you are the source of all life and all goodness. We ask for your blessing upon this meal we are about to share. Bless all those who have made it possible, those who have prepared it, Dom and Lori, those who will be serving us. Bless all of us gathered here, and in a special way, bless our Jubilarians. If we could raise our glasses, please, as a toast to our Jubilarians. We are deeply grateful for each one of you. You have been gift to us and to countless others. We wish you wisdom's abundant blessing as you continue on the journey so well lived to this point. We love you dearly. Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.